Hi, this is Muriel Anderson, and you're logged on to guitar.com. So hope you come back and visit, and check out murielanderson.com sometime too. Thanks. It was a natural progression after you learn to play the chords and do a couple of the bass drums that I was doing in my first performance song. And after that, you know, after bass runs, then you start playing melodies. And so my teacher, Ann Jones, started introducing me to some melody playing, and she had was starting a bluegrass ensemble group, and I joined that and just fell in love with bluegrass immediately. So I learned a flat pick, and Doc Watson was my biggest influence. And so I learned all that finger picking and the flat picking that Doc did. Here's one tune. This is called. Let's see if I remember this. You're pulling things from way back. This is called Doc's Guitar, a piece by Doc Watson. Let's see how much of it I remember. Alternating bass stuff. After that, I went into some Merle Travis and to learn some kind of easy arrangements of Merle Travis too, as he did a lot of that alternating bass, that fingerpicking stuff. Second string there, so you've got 5, 4, 3, 6, 2, 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 6, 2, 4. Same pattern, just one of the notes left out. And that's what I did there. Except that I added some melody notes. So you're still going 5, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 6, 4. That's it. Of course, I'm calling out the numbers of the strings. So. And that's the same pattern, but I left out 6, 2, 4. I left out the last beat, 6, 3, 4, 6, 4, 6, 4, 6, 4. They're all variations on pluck the outside two strings and pluck the inside two strings. Well, I actually wrote a book on the subject, so I wrote a book called Building Guitar Arrangements from the Ground Up. And that's one of the exercises that you do in there. You get a finger-picking pattern going. So, and basically what's consistent in all of that is that your bass is going back and forth, 5, 4, 5, 4. So you get the thumb used to going back and forth regardless. And then the first thing you do is practice. So you play one note at the beginning of each measure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Then I'm going to try to put it on beat 2. 1, 2. Beat 3, 1, 2, 3, now on beat 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And pretty soon I can play it on any beat I want, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. Okay, so then practice playing it on the off beats, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 1, 2, 3, 4. So that your hand, right hand, has the flexibility to play on any beat as you desire while you keep that bass going. And then after you have that happening, you say, okay, I can play on any beat while I keep this bass going. Then the only other thing to add is to be able to play any note on any beat while you keep that going. So you can practice. Of scales or melodies. Whatever pieces you want to play. So it's a gradual working towards being able to keep a pattern going and throw the melody in on top. They taught us the repertoire. They taught us, so here's a Earl Travis tune, here's a John Watson tune. And then I started looking at it and saying, well, this is consistent. Why can't I make up my own tune kind of like this? And so a lot of it was just kind of figuring out the obvious. And then the process of writing the book was just writing down what the obvious that I figured out, just to make it a little bit more accessible for other people so they didn't have to go through the learning process the long way. Doc Watson was influenced, of course, by Muriel, and also Chet Atkins was a big influence of Doc's, and later a huge influence of mine. So Doc came out of more of the real Southern roots, real Southern old-timey roots, and he did a lot of country blues, like this one. Travis played with a kind of a sort of a feel, where he instead of doing 6-2-4 like I'm doing this, he would do 6-2-1 strum, a little strum with his thumb. So if I were playing that real Merle Travis style, I'd kind of swipe that last one like a little kind of like a honky tonk player doing a little chord there. And Chet did a little bit more, a little cleaner style playing, where he played more single notes and then developed the style. It's much more elaborate playing. I do an arrangement of his Mr. Bojangles. Thank you.
beautiful.
Of course, I do a little improvisation and everything.